Hi everyone, my name is Kelsey. I'm a part of the support team here at Tripleseat. This video is going to cover the difference between your document template and your document layout. We will also review how to make basic edits to your template and layout. When you choose from your document menu within an event, that's where all your document templates that you have available live. When you add that document template to an event, you will first fill out the information within the template. These text box and pick list fields make up your document template. This is where you'll input all of your event details and information that will show up on your different layouts. You can have certain fields populate on certain layouts, which can be controlled in your settings. You will see fields for pick list items, text box fields for notes, images, a billing widget, and venue terms and conditions. When you save this, all of your layouts will automatically populate for you. Examples of layouts are the contract, event order, invoice, and kitchen sheet. Your document templates and layouts are super customizable, so next I will take you to my settings page so I can show you how to adjust them if needed. We will now head over to settings, click documents, and here is where you can control all of your templates and layouts. You may have only one set of documents or multiple based on your venue's needs. There are a few reasons why you may want to have more than one document template. Some of those reasons might include templates for your different locations within your group, templates for different types of events, maybe a buyout or a small private dining event, or even events that require a different billing setup. For example, a catering contract that may have a delivery fee, maybe a different service charge, or a special type of contract. If you were to make an edit to a template, you would hover over to the right-hand side and select Edit Template Content. You will notice this page looks very similar to the way it looks when adding this document set to an event, but what I'm doing here is editing this template for future use. Any information or detailing fields that appear on your layouts will populate from sections of your template here. One of the most common questions we receive in support is, how do I update my terms and conditions? You will make edits within your template. You will scroll down to the terms field and make your changes here. It is important to note this will only affect newly created documents moving forward, so it won't retroactively affect any documents that have already been created and have already been signed. You can also add what we call merge fields by right-clicking your mouse within your text field sections to populate certain information per event, like the event name or venue location. You will find the Save button in the top left corner. At the top, I can select Template Properties to rename this template or assign this template to multiple locations. I can recover any deleted sections here or click on any of my layouts to easily edit and jump from one layout to the next. I can also utilize the field section at the bottom of my navigation menu to add additional information to my template. For example, if I wanted to add a new food notes field to my kitchen sheet, I can drag and drop my text box field to my template to use. I will name the text field food notes. When finished, I will be sure to select Save in the top left corner. Once I've added food notes to my template, I now want to choose the layouts I want it to appear on. So for example, I'll go into my kitchen sheet layout. I can reference my document navigation tool and drag and drop an additional field to appear in the layout. I will drag and drop my newly created food note field listed under layout items as our example. Once we place the food notes field where we need it to show, we can click on the text field to make further adjustments, like adding an embeddable header. You can make the header embeddable, so if you don't have any food notes on a specific event that you build, the header will not even appear. This helps clean up the layout and not include any unwanted information that you don't need. To add an embeddable header, I like to copy and paste from an existing header. So we will click into the Kitchen Notes header, click Command A to select all, and copy the text. Next, we will click on the newly added food notes field, enable the header, and paste in our copy text. The last step is replacing the name with the customer-facing header. You will then save this layout. Next, I will show you how to make other edits to your layout. Some reasons why you may want to make an edit to a layout is to adjust the way it looks, rearrange items, or add or remove items that appear in the layout. I'm going to edit the contract as an example. If I was looking to rearrange items, I would drag and drop where I'd like the fields to appear. I can further customize fields by clicking on the field within the layout to make certain changes, like add a border or show price or quantity. You can also change the text alignment, the style, font size, or color, or choose whether you'd like to see the long or short description. If I wanted to remove something from being visible on this layout, I can click on that field and click Remove Field. You will find all of your available fields in your Layout Items section. You can also click on Layout Properties from here to adjust the layout as a whole. You can adjust the layout name, see which locations have access to this layout, modify the font style, size, add a border. You can also make this layout internal for you and your team only, so there will not be a share button available when in the Documents tab of an event. Here, you can also enable Advanced PDF Converter feature, which allows you to input headers and footers. You can also find the design elements, which are Tripleseat fields, to add additional layout items, such as a signature, a two-column container, or maybe even a gratuity selector. I can drag and drop from here to make further customizations to my layout. If I wanted to add a signature as an example, I can drag and drop to where I'd like it to belong. If I click on the field, I can adjust the wording too. Something to note, any change you make to a layout will affect not only newly created documents moving forward, but will also affect documents that have already been created. So in this example, contracts that have already been created will now show this second spot for signature. And if we were to add further design elements, like a divider or a two-column container, that would affect the design of past contracts as well. Once set, you will click Save at the top left corner. Now let's take a look at another event and add documents to see our changes in action. I want to, again, select the Docs tab and select Add a Document to this event. I can add in food and food notes to this document set. I will save this, and then we'll take a look at the kitchen layout to show you the newly created food notes field. If you have any questions or need help editing your templates or layouts, feel free to reach out to the support team through the Help and Questions button, and you can send us an email so we can get you started. Have a great day, and thanks for watching.